Hi, Jess here from nigesa.co.uk. Thank you for joining me today. As you can see, I'm using the Mosaic Mood bundle today. So we've got the stamp set and the coordinating punch. Lovely to have a new label punch with us. And the lovely DSP. And I've made this card here, and I'm going to make it again, but just change the colours slightly. Okay, so we have this stamp set. So there's like a tree there, but you can use that bit in other ways. And we've got a potential border there if you re-stamp it. We've got a nice thank you, a beautiful little sort of mosaic flower, little flower element there. And then this, these two sentiments. Okay, it's a cling mount stamp set, and I've got the stamps that I'm going to use already mounted. The paper I've shown you before. Let's do a quick flick. So we've got these beautiful roses, and this is what page I'm using today, and then that lovely mosaic on the other side. Another rose pattern there. It's the same pattern, different colours, and this one hasn't got the speciality element on it, but that green one has. Those are those lovely sort of flower mosaic circles. And then we have the birds. I love this striped one. I think this is possibly my favourite one. And then we have some more of those flowers on the back. And then we have these birds. So like the other birds, but these ones have got the speciality bit. Fairly simple to fussy cut those. I don't usually fussy cut, but you never know, I might on that. And then this lovely mosaic background, which we've got there with the speciality element on it, and then another stripe on the other side, which of course I love. Okay, and it's slightly thicker than our normal paper, this one as well, a bit like the Share What You Love was in the last catalogue. So yeah, I really like that about it. So to make this card, I'm changing the colour up. I'm going to use Blushing Bride. So the colours in this suite are Garden Green, the new Terracotta Tile, Blushing Bride, Crushed Curry, and Soft Suede. So you could use any one of those colours. In this one, I've got a Garden Green background, and then I've used the Terracotta Tile here. Okay, so this little ribbon element that I'm going to be adding is from Arts and Crafts, believe it or not. So I love this set for all its sort of stationery bits, but it's got these three borders, and I think it's worth it for them, to be fair. So I love this button border. I used that on some little handbags, you may remember. Oh, and I've managed to bend that one. So I'm used this to make some lovely handles on this, and I've used the button there as a focal point. That's another lovely stitched border. And then this one I really like. It's like a lacy border, and it's got stitching on it as well, which I think's brilliant. Oh, and I've just dropped it. I've really got to pick it up, because otherwise it will be lost forever in the mound of paper scraps which's on the floor. Okay, and then these I've already pre-cut, these two panels, so I've just got one that way and one that way. I could have chosen it that way. I think I'm going for that way. I want the butterfly on it. So I've cut it using the stitched framelets, the rectangle stitch framelets, and I've used the third smallest going down to cut out these two here. Okay, but we're going to do some stamping first, so I'll get that done. So I'm going to move those bits. That's just my standard C6 card, which is half a piece of cardstock cut in half and then scored in half. So we're going to use some Blushing Bride on this card. And so I've got my tree mounted, got my tree trunk, got my sentiment, and that's just reminded me that I need some soft suede. There we go. Wasn't too far away, because I have been designing on my desk, and my desk is just adjacent really, so it's not very far away. So I'm gonna stamp the sentiment, And you can see there from the remnants there of where I've stamped it before that lots of our, I'm going to do it twice just to see what stamping off looks like. That's a bit too light, isn't it? Oh well, that's fine. So when you punch it out, it doesn't leave a border. It's left in there. So we haven't got that border around it. Right, so on the inside of the card, I am going to stamp off on that one. I'm just going to do a little tree there. So stamp this up, stamp it off, stamp it down. And then to decorate the front, you can see on the card there, I've got these coming up from the top and the bottom. So I'm just gonna stamp on that side over to the middle and then come in the other side to give myself a little bit of a border there. And I might just fill that gap in like so, and then we'll do the same coming up from the bottom. Again, I'll go back in and fill that gap in there. There. So that's my little border that I've created. So we just need some soft suede to finish the tree off. These are what we call distinctive stamp sets, stamps, I think they're distinctive, which means they're done in such a way that you get light and dark from the stamp. There's no stamping off, but you've got light and dark within that, which I think is pretty cool, and it's the way that the stamp's been made. Okay, so now we can start sticking this together. Let's get my card elements back in. Right, so we need to punch this using our punch. I'm going to use that one, not that one. So we line up, and I say you don't get the usual border with this one. It cuts so it leaves bits in the cardstock, which is really nice. Okay, so I'm going to glue this one down. So I just think that makes a lovely frame. This. So I'm kind of making my decision about how I want them to be on there. Yep, going to go down there because I want to see that butterfly. Although I could go higher. Nope, lower, like so. So that is how I want it. So I'm turning it over on the back, taking a pencil, and I'm just going to mark on the back where I want it stuck. So I can put glue around these bits and stick that onto it. So lining up with those pencil marks. And that's got it right where I want it. So now I want to stick my ribbon element on. So I'm going to put some glue on the back of my hand. And then just tap this lacy bit on. Let me just double check. Just so I can line it up on my grid mat. And then just fold it over like so. And then that's ready to get stuck on. So I'm going to put some glue all the way over this. Glue this in. And then that's me gluing down, and then I'm just going to pop the sentiment up on some dimensionals. That's so cute there. So we get our dimensionals. It's great that I've got my little adhesive holder to the side here, because then my adhesive's always here. It's great. So pop that on there. It's really difficult to get straight when you've got slanted elements on, but that's that. So there it is, using the garden green, and there it is using the blushing bride. So which do you like best? I'm not sure, but you could now do it with crushed curry. You could change that up, so that's garden green. You could do it with the terracotta on the background. So changing the colour changes the look. And as a last little bit, I don't know if you can see on there, but I just put some Winkostella on there. I think it's running out actually. So all I did was put some, so that it's a bit like the DSP, got little bits of shiny bits on some of the elements, but not all of them. To give it just a little hint of some shine. Don't think you can see that, but it is there. Okay, hope you like that. All the details will be over on www.nigeza.co.uk. There's little buttons appearing up here for going to the blog, going to subscribe, going and watching another video. It could well be that side, I can't remember. Okay, see you again soon. If you want to buy anything, there is links to my shop down below. Okay, see you soon.